I'm Kamantha Naidu for Investment Pitch Media. Astra Exploration has provided an exploration update on its flagship Pampa Paciencia project in Chile. The 3,840-hectare road-accessible, low-sulfidation, epithermal gold-silver project is located within an active mining district less than 15 kilometers from two major mines, Sierra Gorda and Spence, and 5 kilometers from the ferrite mine in the Antofagasta region in northern Chile. The current exploration program combined property-wide mapping and sampling, geophysical surveys, and localized trenching to define a larger district and identify the highest priority initial drill targets. Highlights include the identification of 3 quartz vein float sample fields totaling 8.5 kilometers with new zones identified in the west of the property, under thin cover along with surface float samples up to 12.6 grams per ton gold equivalent 3 kilometers northwest along strike with the main Paciencia vein in the north zone. Work to date indicates the presence of a large LSE system beneath a shallow cover. Some of these vein floats returned high-grade precious metals up to 11.35 grams per ton gold and 152 grams per ton silver, significantly extending the prospective area to the west, well beyond the previously known surface anomalies circled in blue. 3 main northwest-southeast trends are defined with these surface float anomalies: the north zone, the central and south zones, and the Impaciencia, the same trend that extends to the past-producing ferrite mine 5 kilometers southeast. Trenching focused on confirming the strike continuity of the Paciencia vein in the north zone. This area will be the company's first drill target to follow up open intercepts in historical drilling, including hole PP15007, which returned 7.71 grams per ton gold and 46.6 grams per ton silver over 3.75 meters, approximately 80 meters below surface. 640 kilometers of ground magnetic surveying revealed large magnetic lows interpreted as hydrothermal alteration related to the vein system. 13 trenches have been completed at the north zone, expanding outward from historical trenches along an interpreted extension of the vein identified in the magnetic survey. 250 trench samples are at the labs, and the company expects to receive those results later in February and will include them in a detailed map of the trenching program. Joining us today is CEO Brian Miller to discuss the company and today's news. Welcome, Brian.
Thanks for having me here, Kamantha. It's a pleasure, and indeed an exciting time as we release the preliminary results on our exploration at Pampa Paciencia. And we look forward to receiving some assays back and starting a drill program here shortly. It's quite exciting. Our preliminary field work, as you know, there was some historical significance that was revealed in some of the previous exploration. And our work over the past several months has expanded that opportunity greatly. We did nearly double the claim group. And our preliminary results indicate that there is potential for a much bigger system below cover here. So quite a bit more opportunity than what we had originally anticipated with the project. So I think that this upcoming drill program is going to be quite exciting. Just to get into some of the details, I think that Astra right now presents an exceptional opportunity to investors. We are a newly formed company, just listed on TSXV last month. We have an exceptional team of technical expertise as well as operational experience in our jurisdiction of interest. These are people at the board level and management level that have been credited with multiple discoveries of the specific type that we are looking for and in our jurisdiction of interest. So quite an exceptional brain trust in the company itself. The company's got a very tight share structure. We listed with just over 25 million shares on a fully diluted basis, no warrants outstanding. We raised over $2.2 million at 30 cents as a private company without a warrant. And our drill program this upcoming month is fully funded. So we have sufficient money in the treasury to complete this and have a little bit of cushion left over. A bit about Astra. Our flagship asset is called Pampa Paciencia. It is a recent epithermal discovery in northern Chile. It's within 15 kilometers of two major operating mines. Fantastic infrastructure, low elevation, so year-round exploration season, skilled workforce nearby. So really is an exceptional jurisdiction, both from a logistical and operational point of view, but specifically as far as geological endowment. Just a quick history on it. It was discovered in 2015 by a major company that was exploring for copper. The short of it was, as they were exploring for copper, they found this epithermal vein. They followed it up with very limited drilling and trenching, and that returned some very interesting results, but it was just never followed up. This was quite interesting to us because our exploration thesis on a broader scale was the precious metals opportunity in Chile, due to the exploration largely being focused on copper historically. Chile is known for its copper mines. It's the world's largest producer of copper. And that's where most of the exploration has been focused, and much less so towards these epithermal systems, these precious metal systems. And we're aware that there's several very attractive properties that have largely been held in the hands of majors or other parties for several years, and they're just not a priority. So it really is an exceptional jurisdiction for discovery. And Pampa Paciencia was a project that was a prime example of this. And so we acquired that interest from another junior company, and we have an 80% interest in those claims. SQM owns the other 20%. And after we acquired the core claims, we then staked an additional group of claims to the west that we own 100%, and that nearly doubled the size of the property. Great looking land package in an exceptional jurisdiction. Just a quick note on some of the historical results. As I mentioned, there were some trenching results and drill results that produced some quite interesting numbers, and that includes a hole 7 that they drilled in 2015. At about 80 meters below surface, they intersected 3.75 meters of 7.7 gram gold and 46 gram silver. Then in another hole, they had another interval of, I think, just over 2 meters at about 8 gram gold and 29 gram silver. What's interesting about this is that there's probably a 600 meter strike length there that has never been drill tested along strike. It's completely open on a 600 to 700 meter strike length of this vein structure, and it hasn't been drilled down to depth. And based on what we know of these systems, that's a lot of room there to host multiple ore shoots. And these ore shoots can occur in discrete zones of these vein structures. And so anytime you get into a structure like this, it warrants follow-up. And that just hasn't been done. So we literally could be approaching a project that had the discovery hole drilled and was just never properly followed up. This is where the importance of, as I mentioned, some of the people on our team really comes into play here. At the board level, Darcy Maroud, he's a director, and he led the Meridian team, now Yamana Gold, that discovered the El Peñon deposit. And this is a world-class mine, 175 kilometers south of our project. Similar mineralization, similar age date, hosted both in the Paleocene. And this is a world-class endowment mine. I mean, this is almost 8 million ounces of gold and 216 million ounces of silver. So Darcy saw this from discovery through production. So he's well aware of what these things take to discover, develop, and put into production. So a fantastic brain trust at the board level. Charles Funk is also on the board. He's part of the Vizsla Silver team. He was VP of exploration there when the Napoleon prospect was discovered at the Panuco district property they have. Then down at management level, our head of exploration is Diego Guido. He is a globally recognized epithermal expert. He was credited for the discovery of the Pingüino deposit in Santa Cruz, Argentina. And he's been a consultant for 25 plus years. He has seen low sulfidation systems like we're looking for of all scales and sizes. So he's very well versed, and he knows what he's looking at in an early stage, which so far has been an exceptional asset that we have in-house. So we really do have an exceptional technical team specific to the type of deposit we're looking for. And, you know, that's just on the technical front. We still have, you know, the business team as well. Our CFO, Mahesh Leonash, he's also part of the Vizsla team, but he's previously worked for a company in Chile. So he's well aware of the jurisdiction, knows how to operate there, knows the ins and outs. Very smart guy, very driven. He brings a lot more to the table than your typical CFO. Roberto Bittner is our VP and country manager based in Santiago. So we have a local presence there on the ground. He's got an exceptional business network. He worked at Yamana for several years with Darcy, and he's just a guy who knows how to get stuff done. Great business relations. He's got lines on properties and opportunities. And over the past several months, these guys have proven themselves overwhelmingly capable of executing, even in especially difficult environment created by COVID. They've managed to get stuff done on time and in an exceptional way. So I just can't say enough about the team. So we really are in quite the enviable position right now, I think, and have probably one of the greatest value propositions in our space, I believe. The idea with building a quality portfolio, again, as I mentioned, we think that Chile is one of the best opportunities that we know of for precious metals discovery. We picked up Pampa Paciencia, but then we also acquired a second project called Cerro Bayo. It's in the Maricunga. It's a high sulfidation porphyry gold target, which doesn't fit our core thesis. However, it's well within the technical expertise of our team. The interesting thing about this project is it came to us because of who the team is and what their accomplishments have been and what their reputations are. And we picked it up for a very good deal. So very low risk to the company and very real potential to add some near-term value. As I mentioned, it is in the Maricunga, so it's higher elevation. It's more difficult in a shorter exploration season. But the metal endowment of that region is just second to none. I think there's roughly a 180-kilometer belt there that hosts close to 100 million ounces of gold and 15-plus billion pounds of copper. So really is an exceptional area. The project was explored by a major company in 1990. They drilled 8 holes. I think the deepest was about 200 meters. The information that we have is historical, but we know we've confirmed the company that did the work. And so that speaks to the quality of work that was probably done. But that did return some very interesting gold results at and near surface that by regional standards is considered economic ore grade. So hasn't seen any exploration since then. And we picked it up with the idea that we could either, there's a lot of preliminary work that we can do on that, some really smart work to add value, but it's also a potential joint venture option too. So perhaps there's a way to further increase the value that it brings to, that it creates for Astra in a very low risk manner. Well, thank you, Kamantha. I appreciate the opportunity to be here and look forward to connecting again soon.
Thank you, Brian. The shares, which began trading on the TSX Venture Exchange on January 26th, are currently trading at 27 cents. For more information on the company and its other projects, please visit the company's website, astra-exploration.com. Contact Brian Miller, CEO, at 208-830-0869 or by email, brian.miller@astra-exploration.com. I'm Kamantha Naidu for Investment Pitch Media.